Cheryl moved to Puerto Amuez, Panama about a year ago. In this video, she shares her experience and advice on shipping your stuff to Panama. Cheryl didn't want to be videotaped, so you'll hear her, but you won't see her.
I'm Betsy from Living in Panama, the place for information and advice on being an expat in Panama. Interested? Click subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss a video.
You seem to be an expert on shipping your stuff down Panama. Tell us, what do you think somebody who's thinking about moving to Panama should know about shipping?
When I decided I was going to move to Panama, my next big question was, am I going to take anything or am I going to leave it all here and start over again in Panama? And of course, for me, I don't have an abundance of money, so it's a matter of economics. Can I afford to ship to Panama? Or do I have to leave all this stuff, even the furniture my father made for me that I love looking at, and my car that is like so reliable, and what should I do? Of course, you look on all these forums, and you see people saying, don't bring anything. Just start all over again. It's too expensive. It's way too expensive. Bringing your car is too much of a hassle. You just stay all day at the port, and you just have to stand there in the scorching sun all day. So those things weren't very promising in terms of bringing these. Then I started checking prices for shipping. And in the United States, the shippers make it like super, super hard to get that information. They won't just quote you a price over the phone. They want to come to your house. They want to check it out. They ask you a gazillion questions. What do you have here? How many rooms? What are you doing? And then they end up quoting you something like $11,000 to $14,000 from door to door.
Wow.
From door in the United States to door in Panama. And that just wasn't going to happen. Just was not going to happen. So I got so tired of dealing with these shippers. And then one day I found something, a shipper called iContainers.com. iContainers.com. They're actually a company out of Spain. And they don't deal with all that malarkey about how many rooms, how many breaches of furniture, how many this, how many that. They'll quote your price. Do you want a 20-foot container or do you want a 40-foot container? Doesn't matter how many pieces of furniture you got. Doesn't matter the weight. All they want to know, 20 or 40-foot container.
That's simple?
Very simple. They ask you where you're moving from, port you're shipping to, and then they give you a quote immediately. They send a truck to your house. It's up to you to load it or get friends to help you load it or to, in my case, I just hired a local moving company to load all my furniture and all my household goods and my car because that was a lot easier for me. Of course, the destination, where it's moving from, where it's going to, it's going to make a difference. If you're about 2 hours from a port, your house is like 2 hours from a port, a 20-foot container is going to run you about $2,700. And a 40-foot container is going to run you about $3,100. Now, I can't say those will be the same prices if you're shipping out of Kansas, because that's a long haul for a truck driver or a train from Kansas to port. So you would just have to go online. You can get the quote online. You can call them. They're very friendly, and they'll just give you the price. Then the next question was, take my car or don't take my car? I knew I had a super reliable car, but you read all this stuff on the forums. Oh, it's too much problem, it's too expensive, blah, 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 blah. Forget all that, it's not true. I ship my car in my 40-foot container along with my household goods. There are two ways. I came in on a pensionado visa. So on a pensionado visa, I could have done a situation where I didn't pay any taxes on the car coming in because it was over 7 years old. However, if you do that, it puts you into a different process where they will keep your car for 2 to 3 weeks and you have to pay the daily cost on it, storage. My customs lady, and it's very important to have a very good customs agent who gets back to you with all your questions immediately, calculated the cost of what I would pay if I paid all of the duties. Okay? Not just the tax, but the tax and all the duties versus what it would cost me to go through the other process for a pensionado visa. What people don't say on all these forums is that on the pensionado visa, you have to hire an attorney to do half of the customs work to bring it in duty-free, and you have to pay a customs person to do the other half. Then you have the daily storage fees. So by the time you calculate all these costs and you compare it with what would happen if you just pay the full amount of duties, it came out to be about $150 difference. So what do I want? Do I want my car in 2 days, or do I want to wait 2 or 3 weeks and go through some hassles? Needless to say, I paid the $150 extra dollars. My car, my container, arrived in Panama City on a Wednesday. It was here in Puerto Reyes by that following Saturday, same week. Got the car off, got all the goods in, piece of cake. A good customs agent. We're also happy to find local moving companies from Panama City to wherever you're living. Bringing my car here was one of the best things I ever did. They say you have a lot of problems with parts and everything else. Well, here in Puerto Reyes, we live very, very close to the border. We call Frontera, Paso Canoas, and there are like these huge, huge car park places with stores down there, just huge. And I did need to get some parts for our car that I finally worn out. Went right down to Paso Canoas for my Honda. It was a Honda. Went right down to Paso Canoas. They had the car parts. We put it right in, no problem. So anybody even that lives anywhere in the Cherokee region, before you like freak out and think you have to go to a dealership or you have to go somewhere else, check with Paso Canoas first, because chances are those big parts stores will have the part that you need.
I think that's good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For more information on living in Panama, please click the link below. Thanks for watching.